हेलो गाइस, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल फलक्स कोडिंग वर्ल्ड। टुडे वी बी मेकिंग अ मेलन बाउंस गेम इन स्क्रैच। सो लेट्स सी हाउ इट वर्क्स। वी कैन मूव द स्क्रैच कैट विद द लेफ्ट एंड राइट एरो कीज एंड आफ्टर सम टाइम द मेलन स्टार्ट फॉलिंग डाउन। फॉर एवरी सेकेंड वी गेट वन स्कोर। So see the melon start falling down and we have to touch it to get it up. We have to avoid making it fall and whenever a melon falls down the game ends. We'll be making this game in 3 steps. Getting the cat to move, multiple melons and scoring and scenery. Step 1. Getting the cat to move. In this step we'll code the cat to move when left or right arrow key is pressed. Open a new project and name it Melon Bounce. This is the cat sprite we are going to use in the project. Name it to cat instead of sprite 1. Now go to the event section. We are coding it. Take a when green flag click block and then in the control section take a forever block. Inside the forever block take 2 if then blocks. Then go to the sensing section and take a key pressed block and put it in both of them. Now name the first key pressed block in right arrow and the second one to left arrow. Now go to the motion section and take a change X by block and put one in both of them. In X we want to change X by 10 and in left arrow we want to change X by minus 10. So keep here minus 10. Now at the start of the game we wanted to go to x, we wanted to go to minus 120 and minus 180, and in y we wanted to go to minus 120. And now go to the look section and take a next costume block and put it after the change Y X by block in both of them. So now we can move the cat. See, it will go here and we can move the cat left and right. So now we have completed step 1. Step 2, multiple melons. In this step we'll be uploading melons and coding them to move up and down. Now go to the sprite library and choose the watermelon. In this watermelon, go to the code section and take a when green flag click block. When green flag click, go to the motion section and take a set rotation style block and put it to don't rotate. So it will not rotate. Then take a go to block and go to the operator section and take a pick random block. Here in the pick random block and put one in the X. Pick random X should be from minus 180 to 180 and the X should be 150. Now go to the motion section. Here we wanted to do one more thing. We wanted to point in direction 180. So take a point in direction block and change this 90 to 180. Now go to the control section and take a wait 1 second block and change 1 second to 10. It will wait for 10 seconds. Now take a forever block. Here go to the motion sections and in the forever block put one move 10 steps block. Now go to the control section and take a if then block. Put the if then block inside the forever loop. And then go to the operator section. In operator section, take an AND block. Then go to the sensing section again and take a touching block. Instead of touching mouse pointer, make it edge. And then go to the operator section again and take a equals to block and put it in the second block. Now change this 50 to 180. And then go to the motion section and take a direction block from here. You can see, put it over here. And then go to the sound section and we want to upload a sound from the library. So now click over here in the upload sound box. So now we are in the sound library. We want the sound symbol. So take this sound and now go to the code section and go to the sound section. Take a play sound symbol until done block and put it over here. Then go to the control section and take a stop all block. So if it is touching the ground, then everything will stop. Now take another if then block and again go to the operator section and take a AND block. This time we wanted if touching edge and direction is equal to 0, then point in direction 180. Then if and then go to the sensing section and take a touching edge block. Now edge and again take an equals to block. Scroll to the motion section and take a direction block. Put it in the first space and change this second to 0. If touching edge and direction equals to 0, then I wanted to point in direction 180. So take a point in direction block and change the number to 180. Now we wanted to do one more thing. Whenever it is touching the cat, we wanted to point in the upwards direction. So again go to the control section and take an if then block. Then go to the sensing section and take a touching block and change the touching mouse pointer to cat. If touching cat, then go to motion sections and point in direction 0. So whenever it touches the cat, it will point in upward direction. Now we wanted to make the game difficult. One watermelon isn't easy for that. So now duplicate the watermelons and make 4 watermelons out of it with the same code. Now we don't want all the watermelons to start falling at the same time. So go to the second watermelon and change the wait 10 seconds to wait 15 seconds. Go to the third watermelon, change 10 seconds to 20 seconds. And in the fourth watermelon, change 10 to 25 seconds. So they will start falling one by one and it will be a little easier for the cat to handle. Step 3, scoring and scenery. In this step, we'll be adding a variable called score and we'll be uploading a background. Go to the cat and go to the variable section. In the variable, make a variable called score. Now we have to add a code to cat. Go to the event section and take a when green flag clicked block. Then take a forever block and when starting we want to set the score to 0. And forever we wanted to wait 1 second. Go to the control section and take the wait 1 second block and then we wanted to change score by 1. So change score by 1. So every time it touches the cat, every time after every second, it will change the score by 1. Now here in the backdrops, choose a backdrop from the library. We are gonna take the wall 1. Select wall 1 and the backdrop is here. Now the game is done. Let's test it. So now the watermelons are up. Now and the cat is also moving and the background is also looking good and matching. Score is also increasing after every second. And after 10 seconds, the watermelons are starting to fall down here. And the watermelons one by one each are falling down. And if the watermelon falls down, the game is ending. So that means the game is working. Thank you for watching my video. Please subscribe to my channel and click on the bell icon for notifications. Please like the video if you like this video.